Welcome, all of you. Thank you very much indeed for joining this very important Economist event. And I'm now going to ask each of you to speak in turn, all of you, and then we'll take some questions from our audience and from myself. And I think we'll have about 20 minutes for Q&A. So without further ado, Minister, welcome, Adonis Georgiadis, Minister for Development and Investments of Greece. Thank you very much.
First of all, thank you for the invitation. I have to congratulate you. The pronunciation of my name is not very easy in the English language, and you did very well. In the beginning, mostly. The second time, not so well, to be honest. But I want really to thank you for the effort. And I'm very honored being here and participating to this important discussion about why doing business in the Eastern Mediterranean region now is really important, and for sure it is a big opportunity. I understand that Eastern Mediterranean, for many reasons, came to first news in many places of the planet in the recent months. Mostly because the recent discoveries of natural gas resources in the Eastern Mediterranean made the motion of many interest around these countries, Greece, Cyprus, Israel, Egypt, and gave the expectations of real big investments that they can totally change how we see the energy supply of European Union and European markets the next decades. And I think, especially because, and for security reason, and for consumption reason, it's very important for European Union to have various ways of importing natural gas, Eastern Mediterranean suddenly becomes a much more important place in which, in the future, European consumers could depend on for finding these natural gas resources. The relationships between the Eastern Mediterranean countries, I will make an exemption for Turkey that I will speak a little bit at the end, every day becomes even better, maybe better than anyone could imagine some years ago. Greece, Cyprus and Israel have a trial of one really solid allies in the region. In the recent time, Egypt is coming very close to these three countries, and all of them are making a real strong block of a very steady region that is ready to find solutions. The example of the signing agreement for the exclusive economic zone between Greece and Egypt is an example how these countries can go forward into this new environment and finding ways to improve the business environment. Overall, this, Greece and of course Cyprus, has managed to exit from the recent economic crisis of 2013-14 for Cyprus, 2010 to 17-18 for Greece. But exiting this crisis became much more competitive economies and more steady economies that can really stand now under these big problems that are around the economy of Europe because of COVID-19 and everything. But they prove that they can be competitive, they can produce big opportunities, they have steady political environment, and this is not always the case in the European Union. And as I mentioned before, the expectations of the future are really very big. So you have steady democracies with steady political systems, with good economies that manage to exit from a big crisis, with big expectations, with a new big resources. And if, and this is now the big if, we manage to find a way to have Turkey into a region, because you know Turkey is a country that wants to interfere and change balance almost everywhere. But I'm very optimistic that now, in very strong effort, Turkey understands that being provocative and trying to interfere with other people's business is not the way for them to go forward. And if we manage to put them in an account and make them understand that peace and finding common solution, it's for their own benefit also, will manage to fix a very, very steady neighborhood and good for business. So for all these reasons, I think Mediterranean, Eastern Mediterranean, now it's the place that if you put money, you can have expectation of real good profit and real good revenues in the year to come. And this is why I'm very optimistic that when this vaccine of COVID-19 will come and will find a way to adjust and stabilize the virus, our economies will go fast forward in a much better way than anyone could expect. Thank you very much.